Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching Southeast Channel Line and have top stories. We are tracking for you on Monday, the 24th of June. Indian lawmakers take oath as MPs and a blow over the and speaker election. Pakistani delegation visits India for Indus Water Treaty talks. And Sri Lanka arrests 22 Indian fishermen for alleged poaching. And now for all the details, lawmakers were sworn in as members of parliament on Monday as the newly elected Lok Sabha convened its first session. Minister Narendra Modi, Home Minister Amit Shah and Defence Minister Rajnath Singh took oath as the members of the Parliament. However, Education Minister Dharmendra Pradhan's oath was met with protest and sloganeering by opposition leaders who mocked the recent irregularities in several examinations. The post of pro tem speaker also became issue of flashpoint between the government and the opposition as the Indie bloc alleged that ruling NDA did not follow the convention by appointing Bhartuhari Mahtab, a 7-time MP, as the temporary speaker. The opposition said as per convention, Congress leader K. Suresh, an 8-time MP, should have been the speaker. The opposition bloc also boycotted from the panel to assist Mahtab.
लेकिन मोदी जी संविधान को तोड़ने की कोशिश किए, इसीलिए आज सभी पार्टी के नेता लोग एक होकर ये जो प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे हैं।
Earlier in the day, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, while addressing the media, said that the country hopes and expects the opposition to maintain the dignity of democracy, adding that the people want substance, not slogans. The remarks came as opposition lawmakers staged a protest in the parliament premises on the first day of the session.
सदन में सामान्य मानवी की अपेक्षा रहती है डिबेट की विजिलेंस की लोगों को अपेक्षा नहीं है कि नखरे होते रहे ड्रामा होते रहे डिस्टर्बेंस होता रहे लोग सब्सटेंस चाहते हैं स्लोगन नहीं चाहते हैं देश को एक अच्छे विपक्ष की आवश्यकता है जिम्मेवार विपक्ष की आवश्यकता है
And amid the recent spate in terror attacks in India's Jammu and Kashmir territory, Intel reports have suggested Pakistan-based terror groups are trying to revive terrorism in areas south of the Pir Panjal ranges in the Jammu sector, with around 35 to 40 foreign terrorists being active in the area and operating in small teams with 2-3 in each one of them. Talking to ANI, defence sources have said foreign terrorists are suspected to be former Special Services Group members from the Pakistan Army. They have been trying to revive terrorism in the Rajouri, Poonch and Kathua districts. They said in the recent security review meetings, it was observed that there was a need to further strengthen the second-tier counter-terrorist grid in areas along the international border to plug infiltration attempts. Amid efforts to upgrade human and technical intelligence gathering, the Indian Army has deployed additional troops in the region. Sources suggest forces have been given a free hand to operate in the area against terrorist support infrastructure and there is a likelihood of strong action against such elements. And a Pakistani delegation that arrived in India on Sunday evening as part of the neutral expert proceedings inspected two hydroelectric power projects in Jammu and Kashmir on Monday as part of the Indus Water Treaty talks. The visit amid tight security marks the first time a Pakistani delegation has come to India after the abrogation of special status granted to Kashmir in 2019. The Indus Water Treaty was signed between India and Pakistan in 1960, brokered by the World Bank. The treaty warrants the two sides to meet once a year, alternatively in India and Pakistan. India and Pakistan have engaged in a long outstanding water dispute over two hydroelectric projects. Moving on, a local who was arrested during protest in POJK against inflation has lamented there has been no implementation to provide subsidies on flour and electricity as assured by Pakistan government over which they had called off their protests. A report.
Fahab Hamid Kiani, a resident of Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir who was arrested during protests in May to demand subsidized wheat flour and electricity, has decried torture in jail and lamented no implementation of their demands so far, despite promises. During the massive demonstrations in May, three protesters and one security official were also killed in clashes. An alliance of civil rights group called off the protests following several days of turmoil, as Pakistan PM Shehbaz Sharif approved a grant of 24 billion rupees to help meet most of their demands. But activists have now raised concern over inaction to provide subsidies and any sort of relief.
6 days, हमें समझ लें torture किया गया कि हमें बंद कमरों में रखा गया, बाहर निकलने की इजाजत नहीं है, किसी से मिलने जुलने की इजाजत नहीं है, जो बंदा जिसका कोई जुर्म ही नहीं है, जिस पे कोई FIR नहीं है, कुछ भी जो है, अभी तक मसाइल जो है वो हल नहीं हुए, हमारे बहुत से असीरान अभी भी रिहा नहीं हुए, जिन पे बेबुनियाद और बोगस FIR जो है वो उन पे लगाई गई है और उनको यानी 302 में अंदर किया गया है, जो ASI शहीद हुए उनको उनका जो कत्ल है वो उन पर डाला गया है। हालांकि FIR में पुलिस ने ये चीज़ खुद लिखी हुई है कि इनको उस कत्ल से आधा घंटा पहले हमने अरेस्ट कर लिया था, लेकिन हुकूमत इस वक्त अपनी हठधर्मी पर डटी हुई है और वो अभी तक जो है आवाम को सब्सिडाइज आटा और फ्री बिजली का हक जो है, फ्री बिजली का हक भी उन्होंने ना दिया, 3 रुपये फी यूनिट जो उन्होंने ऐलान किया, 3 रुपये 5 रुपये, तो वो भी जो है अभी तक उन्होंने नहीं दिया।
The activists said there are again signs of unrest over the demands. Locals in POJK say they are fed up of Pakistan government and the stooge authorities in the region, which are only there to fill their treasuries through heavy taxes, while they continue to suffer for even basic amenities.
More than 13,000 Afghan migrants have been deported from Pakistan to Afghanistan in the last 10 days, local media reports have suggested. Since the start of the deportation initiative, a total of 6,20,981 Afghan citizens, including women and children, have been repatriated to their homeland. They entered the country through border crossings in Nangarhar, Kandahar, Nimroz and Herat provinces. This comes as the expulsion of Afghan migrants from Pakistan and Iran has intensified in recent months, with hundreds entering the country daily. This continues despite UN concern over already worsening humanitarian and economic conditions in Afghanistan. The de facto Taliban authorities have renounced the deportations. Moving on, the Sri Lankan Navy on Sunday arrested 22 Indian fishermen and seized their 3 trawlers for allegedly fishing illegally in its maritime boundary. The Navy in a statement said that the Indian fishermen were to be handed over to the Mellary Fisheries Inspector for onward legal proceedings. India and Sri Lanka share an expansive oceanic border without any perceptible demarcation. Fishermen from both the countries frequently stray into each other's territory while netting their catch and end up spending years in jails. This year alone, a total of 204 Indian fishermen have been apprehended for illegally fishing in its water. And a temple in southern India has introduced a lifelike robotic elephant to be used in rituals in an effort to prevent animal cruelty. The mechanical elephant was donated by the animal rights group PETA to the Purnamikau temple in Thiruvananthapuram. The mechanized elephant named Baladasan is 3 meters tall and weighs around 800 kilograms. Kerala has stringent rules for protection of elephants, but they often suffer in captivity due to harsh training and poor living conditions. There have been cases in the past when elephants used for temple ceremonies ran amok, damaging properties and injuring or killing people.
We know elephants are widely used in Kerala for religious and other purpose. And same time, it is so common that the elephants run amok cases are also reported every year in Kerala. As per the Heritage Task Force reports, in last 15 years, 526 people was killed by the elephants used in Puram and other religious purposes. So to rectify all this, we introduced this mechanical elephant, that is the third mechanical elephant in Kerala.
That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.